Let us now move on to native element binding. So observe that we have one property message, which is of type string with the value hello user, and then you have notify set to true. And in the template, we have the display of a message, which is a two-way bound. And we also have a paper input with the value is equivalent to message colon colon value changed. And we have a HTML native element, which is input, which is also bound to this message. Now let us just understand why we are doing this. When there is a change in the value, because this is two-way bound, it automatically raises this particular event called value hyphen changed. So this is the value property. Because the value of that is getting changed, it will raise this particular event called value changed, and this will be done automatically by the polymer. But when we are data bounding this to a input control, which is a native HTML control, this code walks into rough waters. Let us discover the scenario first. So we have these three controls now. So we have the hello user, which is a regular DOM element here. This is the paper input, and this is the native element. So now if we are engaging this from the paper element, you could see that the entry that we are making here is getting reflected as part of this DOM element as well as the HTML native element. But if I do the same thing with the HTML native element, you could observe that the same thing is not reflected back as part of the other two DOM elements. So let us see why this is happening. So when the value of a paper input is changing, it actually raising this value change property for this message. So therefore, this is getting updated at all targets. But when there is a change in the input's value, it does not generate this value hyphen changed event, but instead it is going to generate an event called input event. So since the polymer is not listening to the input event, it simply fails. So in order to make sure that polymer listens to this event, so along with this, we need to subscribe to this particular event called input. So let us observe whether this solution works or not. So let us refresh this. Now if you observe this, the input that we are doing in the native element is also getting updated in this DOM. This is happening because the polymer has started listening to the input event, and so therefore you have achieved this native element binding.